Okay. Hi. We're so glad to be able to have with us our special speaker this evening. I'm so glad that she can be here. She gets around a lot. We see her on the TV almost every week in places. Most of all the places that she is, she's there for the veterans. She goes to the parades. She goes to the VAs, goes to the homes. She does everything that she can for our veterans and for our military. There's some things that she has done behind the scenes too. Not only but her, but also with her husband. I can tell you that a few years back, there was a time in my life when I needed some help, and that came through immensely for me. And so I've never forgot the Dingells and so what they do for us. So we are honored tonight to have with us Congresswoman with us, Debbie Dingell.
Thank you, Larry. It's great to be with all of you. And I first want to say thank you to all of the veterans, the men and women who have served us. And today, Veterans Day, we are celebrating you. So please let us give a huge round of applause for all the veterans that are here tonight. And Larry does so much for so many. So when he called me this week and said, would you say a few extra words than just rather than greetings? I said, of course I will. But I also remember the very first time I came here, Brenda Stumbo, who's the great Ypsilanti Township Supervisor, is the very first person who brought me to this hall and wanted me to meet all of you. And I've been to many Veterans Days on this day, and to Adam Semke and Ronnie Peterson, who are two great state legislators from this area. It's also, all of us are here to honor you. You know, it's been a fabulous 2 days. I've been at both of the VA hospitals to celebrate and honor our veterans, and I've been to a number of other veteran ceremonies around that just started with the parade last Sunday, and then the last couple of days have been many of the local municipal celebrations and different halls with veterans. You know, and Veterans Day is an opportunity for all of us to come together as community. By the way, community is the strength of democracy. But for us to come together as community to salute the men and women who have served for us. And I want to say how great it is to see our youngest generation here and to see the Boy Scouts and to have you all, why don't all the Boy Scouts here stand up so we can salute you and thank you for coming. But it's a chance for you to learn about those brave men and women who fought to defend us in this country. Unfortunately, I don't think we have anybody from World War I. I'm married, and we are still saluting the greatest generation, the World War II veterans. I'm married to one, as I said, John Dingell, who wanted to be here and loves all of you. Those who served in the Korean War, those that served in the Vietnam War, and we must always remember that they were not treated right when they came back to this country. We thank every one of you who served in the Vietnam War and fought to keep us free in this country. And it needs to be a lesson to all of us on this Veterans Day that the men and women who are brave enough to fight for us, to protect our liberties, our freedoms, that we must always be there for them. And then we've had Operation Freedom, deserts of Iraq, the mountains of Afghanistan, and unfortunately, even we've seen deaths in Africa in these past few weeks. We salute everyone who's fought for democracy and freedoms around the world. You know, and we also, today's supposed to be, I was listening to the radio this morning, Veterans Day is a day to celebrate the men and women who served. We do want to remember those that gave their life, but we're here to thank you who have served us. What we need to do today is to renew our commitment to the 2 million troops and reservists, the families, and the more than 21 million veterans across the country. So what we need to do is to keep our promises, to strengthen our quality health care for our veterans, to provide benefits transition, and educational assistance that you've earned. And when I leave here, I'm going to an event in Lincoln Park. We're going to be raising money to try to help homeless veterans. There's too many of them these days. People come back and they have a hard time transitioning, and we've got to help them. People who have fought for our country should never have a hard time finding a job or finding a roof over their heads. And we all have a responsibility as community to help be there for them. President John F. Kennedy once said, as we express our gratitude, we must never forget that the highest appreciation is not to utter the words, but to live by them. You know, I'm going to make just a couple more observations, because we're living in interesting times. I think as a country, we're focused far more on what divides us than what unites us. I think too many people are trying to divide this country with fear and hatred. I want to tell you, I've never been prouder to be an American in many ways. For these young boys, you're going to start when you're in school, you're going to learn the words freedom of speech, freedom of religion, civil liberties. We take that for granted. We don't know how lucky we are to live in a country that we can say whatever we want, when we want. No matter what your religion, you can go to the Catholic Church, the Baptist Church, the Jewish synagogue, the Muslim mosque. That's who we are as Americans. And so many people around the world don't have those freedoms that we have. And there's some that are trying to destroy us. This Veterans Day is a day to focus on what unites us and what makes us so strong as a country. You know, in our very own community, we have one of the Medal of Honor winners, Charles Kettle, who got the medal 2 years ago. He is such an inspiration to any of you who can talk to him, and talks about what it means to be an American and what our freedoms mean. You know, the other thing I want to remind us all is that 22 veterans are committing suicide a day. We have a challenge. It is very challenging. When people came back from, I actually last night went to this wonderful celebration. There is a gym that's been started downriver by veterans who are suffering from post-traumatic stress. And they, you know that many people, it's not just veterans, people who are suffering from anxiety, depression, fear, will self-medicate. They'll take alcohol or drugs, and it creates more problems if you're suffering from post-traumatic stress. So these fabulous veterans have started this gym so that veterans have a place to go and be with each other, support each other, and to work out, and to be at the gym, to take that stress and that anxiety and work it out in the gym. And then, without any doctors, without any professionals, they get together several times a week around a table and support each other. That's what we've got to do as a community. We got to be there. We got to be there for each other. But when veterans come back home and we see somebody that needs a helping hand, it's all of our responsibilities to put out that helping hand. I have to make sure in my official job, and Ronnie and Adam have to help, we need to make sure we're putting the resources in to help the veterans who have been through some very, very, very frightening, challenging times. But all of us need to be there for the men and women who've served us and for their families. So I guess the last thing I want to say, and by the way, if you've got a healthcare problem, if you're having a problem at, you saw this week that we saw an unfortunate incident at the Ann Arbor Hospital. We're working very closely with the John Dingell Hospital as well. If you've got a problem, I want to know about it. I need you to call our office. You may be the voice that we need to hear about. So we're focused on it. But Tim Wahlberg and I immediately sent a letter. I don't think that our veterans should ever be partisan. We are united. And Tim and I work very closely together to be there, to have town hall meetings for the veterans, to address problems when they're happening at the hospital. We, and I The VA hospital in Ann Arbor is one of the state-of-the-art hospitals around the country. I want to say that. I know that there are issues at the John Dingell Hospital. There are issues at both. You need to tell me. We owe you the best health care that you can get. Tim and I are also, when we had another problem, working on bringing transparency, have a bill that'll probably pass through the Congress in the next month that will require more regular hospitals that we all go to have to be transparent about what's happening on infection rates, surgical outcomes. VA needs to do that too. Tim and I are working on that. But I want to close that say it with this. On the battlefield, the military pledges to leave no soldier behind. As a nation, let it be our pledge that when they return home, we leave no veteran behind. This Veterans Day and every day, let us honor their service with actions that fulfill our commitment to our troops, their families, and the veterans, and that they are worthy of the grateful nation we are. Thank you very much.
Aren't you glad I gave her a few more minutes to speak? That was awesome. The key word is action, doing things. And the American Legion has always been at the forefront of doing things for our veterans. They have done so many things that they lead the way in. And so it's the same thing here in this community with this American Legion. I want us to find things that we can do to make this community as green as it's supposed to be.